All 94.9 FML with Fook and Mishell and Charles Halford.
Hey,
actor from True Detective and now on now in Constantine on NBC Friday nights. We'll chat about that in a second. We were just talking a little bit about some of the you were in musicals.
Yeah.
When you were growing up. And I was going to ask you to maybe like belt out a little bit of Oklahoma, but then you started to talk about
Oklahoma, something and something else. There's something from Oklahoma.
Or what was do you remember what one of the musicals you did back in the day?
I didn't get a lot of solos in the singing, but my senior year I did get some pretty good notice. We did Oliver, and I played Bill Sykes, which is like this big, gruff, evil. And I think that his song was like, I can't. No one remembers my name. So something.
Although it would have been great to see a 6'7" like orphan child.
Yeah. Well, Oliver. I really was going for the Artful Dodger, but they just couldn't see it creatively.
Didn't happen.
Yeah.
I really wanted it to be sort of more of the other you doing some. Hi! Music man, thing, because it just the frame wouldn't fit the tone.
No,
Charles Halford. So let's talk about Constantine for a second. And if you guys remember the
Keanu Reeves Shia LaBeouf movie, that's pretty much what I know of Constantine.
That's what a lot of people know of Constantine. And I hear it's a fantastic little ride.
Yeah,
it's fun. It's based on the same comic book Hellblazer, which is a fantastic comic. If anybody's out there likes comics, go pick up as many issues of that as you can. Hopefully you'll like it. It was funny. There's sort of a debate between comic book fans and the movie, because obviously John Constantine is a blonde British occultist.
And they were like, Keanu.
And they were like, Keanu Reeves. He's American Los Angelino an exorcist.
Hawaiian, Japanese. Yeah. And they're like, what is going on?
But yeah, hopefully, you know, it is funny kind of following the forums, because people be like, oh man, finally, you know, we get to see a proper Hellblazer adaptation. And then someone inevitably is like, not Keanu Reeves, not Constantine. And then somebody inevitably after that is like, well, then read some comic books. It's cool. I mean, it's kind of cool that like there's that many people interested in it. And I'm really proud of what we're doing. And I think the show just really does deliver throughout, you know, this first season. And with any luck, we'll be running for... More
so Constantine
that.
Is an exorcist.
He's sort of a jack of all trades. I mean, he's a con man first. He's a fast talking con man, and he's a street magician. You know, he's sort of a sorcerer, a summoner. He's got a really vast knowledge of spells and you know the movie I think actually made him more of an exorcist than he was in the comics. But we sort of, you know, it's like with any comic book, you get a new writer, new artist, and a new interpretation of like these solid characters. And we're lucky that we get to kind of create a John Constantine chapter.
Tell us about your story and how you fit into all of this.
In the show?
Yeah.
I play the character of Chaz Chandler, which is different than Shia's Chaz in the film.
You're like the muscle.
Yeah. I'm the brawn to Constantine's brains. But at the end of the day, I'm really just like his best friend, you know, and kind of wingman. Like, John has a bad history of keeping friends alive, and most people who know him know that, and run the other way. And Chaz, on the other hand, is right there, you know, kind of with him, you know, we divert a little bit from the comic book Chaz in that, like, I have this ability to kind of survive really horrible things, which is interesting. You know, you get to see me die quite a bit.
Did you have to learn any martial art type stuff to play this role?
No. I mean, it's a work in progress. You know, I took a couple boxing lessons, more just to pass time. You know, and then I'm constantly picking. You know.
Martial, fights.
Yeah, just fights.
Yeah,
you know,
sure,
I was like, oh no, I'm just studying. What'd you say?
Yeah, and this was what I was kind of, because I think changing eating habits is one of the hardest things that you could ever do in life. And I read a little bit about that. You're a vegan. You talked about your love of juicing with Woody Harrelson. When did you pick up veganism?
I picked it up pretty young. I mean, I went vegetarian at age like 13, I want to say. I had a friend who's older sister was vegetarian. She cooked vegetarian. And before that, I didn't even know it was an option. I didn't know you got to choose what you ate. You ate what you were given.
Right.
And I was always a bit of a rebel, and I mean, I guess a sucker for attention. And so I was like, I went home and I was like, I'm not eating meat anymore. Nope. You cook me something special. And, my parents were supportive. And then, a couple years after that, I was pretty involved in like kind of the punk and hardcore scene here as a teenager. And that's when I kind of met veganism. And that's when you see these horrible slaughterhouse tapes, and there was a lot of bands that were really like vegan activist type bands. And that all just made sense to me. And so I was like kind of back and forth, through high school, but then eventually landing on being a really unhealthy vegetarian when I was doing a lot of theater, because at 6'6", I could be 300 pounds and still play really big on stage. But when you try to put that big figure in front of a camera lens, it's like obvious that this guy
needed to eat more.
Needs to cut back a little bit. And so the second time I went vegan, I was 19. So it's been like 15 years. And a lot of that was just, you know, more for kind of dietary reasons, but ethically I agreed with it already. So it just works for me. You know?
Do you have to like eat a whole trough of food? Cause it just seems like to maintain just your natural weight, you'd have to eat it. Some vegetables don't have a lot of calories innately in them.
Yeah, I eat a ton, and I always reference like elephants. You know what I mean? They're vegetarians, right?
They're huge.
But they eat all day. They eat tons and tons of food. So yeah, I eat massive salads.
And I know you're also a craft beer guy. Yeah. You get back to Utah much?
I get back. I try to get back like once, you know, once a year. You know, with this show, I think I'll have more luxury. Well, at least I'll have a set schedule, because like up until this, there's no steady work. It's like you have to be available for any audition that might come up. You have to be available to travel anywhere. But yeah, I make it back here and try to keep up with what's going on here.
Is it tough in the to get the beer that you want when you come back here?
No, I think the craft breweries here are actually really top notch. I mean, I actually brag about Utah craft beers.
Squatters and Epic, and yeah,
New Winter, Wasatch. I mean, they're Red Rock, and I find them like you know, Uinta's got beers in like California, and I'm always the one. Dude, you got to try this. You got to try this. It's awesome.
The people that are into beer here are really into beer here.
Well, I think that's just something like Salt Lake is a super cool city because people just get really into what they're into. I mean, if you even look at the Comic-Con crowd and how big that's grown.
We noticed that this year. Yeah, it was huge.
It's like the third biggest one. Like, and it's only been around for 2 years. And but the same thing, I think, with craft beer, with food, music, art. There's something about this city that really does, people are just really into what they're doing, and then the people who are into that are really supportive, you know? It's a very cool town like that.
Well, I think you're probably a good example of somebody, you know, who grew up in this environment and is now doing great things, and you're proud of the scene, and we think that's awesome.
Well, yeah, and I mean, there's no way I would have been able to do it without the scene, you know? That it was supportive, like, throughout. And there's a lot of people making films and just doing what they want to do out here, which is great.
Constantine is ripe for Comic-Con. Are you excited to, you know, for that to happen?
Excited? I'm a little bit, intimidated. We did San Diego Comic-Con, but we hadn't aired yet. And
that was
pretty wild. I mean, we shot until 3 a.m. on Friday. We got on a plane. We got to San Diego at like 6 a.m, got in a bus, and then just went.
You went to the Mecca.
Yeah, we were doing interviews about a show that we hadn't even read two episodes of. And I kind of skated by because, you know, Matt, there was like a 40-foot tall Matt Ryan Constantine in the Gaslamp Square or whatever that's called there. And then Harold Perrineau, who plays Manny in the show, is known from Lost, and Lost had a big presence there for many years. And so everybody's like, Matt, Harold. And it was like, get out of the way, big guy. I'm trying to get a photo.
Who's this bodyguard? Get out of the way.
And I would step away, and like security would detail me. I was like, dude, really? Like, come on, like nobody's bothering me. And he goes, well, give it a year. Give it a year.
Like, I swear I'm on, look at the IMDb page. Yeah. I swear I'm on the show, guys.
Hey, guys, I think we got to hustle. But Charles, is there anything else that you need us to plug for you? Constantine, Friday nights, NBC?
Yeah, just, I mean, please tune in and tell all your friends. I think you'll enjoy it. And, hit me up on Twitter, at @Charlie_Halford. Follow NBC Constantine, #Constantine. Let's get it out there.
Charles Halford, thank you so much for coming in, man. Best of luck with the show.
Yeah, thank you, guys.